is Tender69046 here, and I'm back with another episode of Tornado Survival. Season 6, episode, I want to say 17? I don't know if it's 17, but I believe it is. And in today's episode, we're going to be working on turning the old base into a farm area, underground farm. So as you know, this is Tornado Survival, and the challenge with that is protecting stuff, and well, tornadoes will pick up your crops and animals, so the best way to avoid this is building it underground, and the best place to do this is probably at the old base. Off camera, I did a live stream, and I got all the stuff moved over from this base to that base over there, and I would like to, I'd like to eventually transform, like, a way to transfer the items, like the wheat and all that, transfer it from here to the storage room. I don't know if that's possible or not. It's probably take a lot of work. But yeah, we got all of our animals here, and do a quick montage of the collection process right now. Enjoy. One pig. Two pig, one cow, oh no, one bunny, two bunnies. Alright, so we've got a bunny in here. Oh, no, come on out. Come on out. Oh lord. That wasn't so bad, as long as the bunny didn't get loose, and it did. Come on, okay. Now we just gotta get these chickens. Okay. You're over here, bunny. Come on. There we go. One sheep, two sheep, and two cows. So, that's how we got all the animals here, all the animals we need. First order of business, is going to be, well, let's sleep so we don't have any issues. It would probably be to dig out the rooms, of course. So this, of course, I gotta stop saying, of course, this way leads down just to our nether portal down there and our poorly lit up cave that's been causing me issues. Ignore that, doesn't matter. This way is going to be to our animals. Ignore this too. I need to get rid of that. So this leads to this. This is potatoes and wheat. I would like to expand this up a level maybe. And then do carrots and beets that are in the game. I don't know how to get them yet. That'd be good. That'd actually be really helpful. And then, so that way it'll be the farm, be the food and stuff, and this way can be the actual animal breeding ground itself. So what I'm thinking for this, just keep it fairly simple. Maybe do it this way. Yeah, do it back one more this way. Whoops, I didn't mean to do that. And then like this. And of course, raise the ceiling up one. And this will be the stalls for each one. Not very humane, I know, but it'll work, actually. I'd like it to be square, you know. Square would be good. Also, was hoping for a little bit more stone in here. Whatever. Dirt. And then, yeah, this will work. And then what we do is we take this gate. Oh, I forgot we have colored gates. That's an issue. I don't have an axe. That sucks. Yeah, so this will be the thing. We'll have to collect oak wood for an axe later. Didn't have any oak wood at the other base either. So either. I'd like for there to be like one close thing in the middle. One, two. Yeah, that's black right here. That'll be a glowstone. And then that grass will grow. And we put the animals inside. So. So what we do is we do this, that, and we can go get some wood. So usually I would time lapse this process, but on last episode we did touch on Hurricane Matthew. It is of course no longer a hurricane. Its energy is recycled back into the atmosphere at this point, so it's no longer a system at all. To be honest, it's. Probably part of a different system. But there are a few things I'd like to touch on that, because for one, at the time of that recording, it looked like the forecast track was for a direct hit on Jamaica. That track shifted east a lot within the next few days, and Matthew actually took a direct hit on Haiti. And if you'd have to choose between Jamaica or Haiti to take a direct hit from a Category 4, which both are not good at all, you definitely wouldn't want it to be Haiti. You'd definitely rather Jamaica get hit. For one, because this next number will pretty much explain why you wouldn't want Haiti to be the one to get hit. And that's because Haiti had almost 1,000... It might have been 1,000. I didn't ever see a final count. They had almost 1,000 people perish from Hurricane Matthew. And, yeah, that number is staggering when you think about it. Considering, you look at 9/11, one of the biggest tragedies in American history. It only had 2,000 people die. And a hurricane killed 1,000 in Haiti, so yeah, it's definitely not the outcome many were looking for to come out of Hurricane Matthew, unfortunately. So yeah, it did do that. After it hit Haiti, it would go on to the Bahamas. Well, ignore that. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Only needs 5 of you. Dang it. Anyways, after it hit Haiti, it would then re-enter into the Caribbean. And, you know, it doesn't really strengthen, it kind of just maintains strength, and then landfalls in Cuba, and then enters into the Atlantic, because, you know, the Bahamas. Where am I going? Oh yeah, gotta get glowstone. So yeah, it's gonna enter into the Bahamas from there, and, well, Matthew struggled a little bit, to say the least. After exiting Cuba, Cuba's got a lot of mountains, and mountains will shred tropical systems that rely on water to keep the inner core strengthened. Mountains will shred that apart. So whenever Matthew's core it hit Cuba, at first it really didn't have any impacts, as many systems will do. After it re-entered back, the core, you know, it usually... You would expect it, you know, warm waters, low shear, all this, the shear in the right direction for it to re-strengthen. You'd expect in the core to re-strengthen and reorganize, and that never really did happen. Now, Bahamas still got hit pretty hard, because even after it hit Cuba, it was still pretty strengthened. It hadn't taken that hit from the mountain jet. It took a minute. It took a while for it to really affect the system directly. So after it re-enters into the Atlantic or the ocean, whatever, it's not going to strengthen. The core microwave images show it kind of strengthened, kind of started to look like it was going to reorganize. And then it goes under eyewall replacement. And eyewall replacement... Holy crap, that was not good. Eyewall replacement is basically when the inner eye of the storm, the core of the storm, it replaces itself, and it becomes bigger. So, basically, when it does this, it becomes less compact. You know, it's bigger across. The winds are more broader across, but they're not as strong. So you got Matthew, an already not so strong storm, is impacted by this, by these mountains. You know, it's already disorganized, and then it enters eyewall replacement after the fact. And this would really, Matthew never got the chance to rapidly restructure or anything like that after Cuba. So although Bahamas did get hit, heading towards Florida, it wasn't a very organized storm. And microwave images would show that. So basically, at that point, it's not really a high-end category 4. It kind of wobbles around 130 miles per hour, which is still a category 4. Definitely a dangerous storm. But the difference is, it got really hyped up. And the next issue with Matthew is many people believed it would make landfall in Florida. You know, people are saying it could landfall there, and they ordered evacuations. Now, these evacuations were right, but the issue is you only had hurricane force winds in Florida, and these people were told they needed to evacuate based on category 4 winds in Florida, and that wasn't the case, and that definitely wasn't the issue with Matthew either. So after it had done all this to Haiti, and of course Haiti, you know, their structures, their houses aren't that great anyways. 3, 4, 5, 6. You know, that really struck them. Ooh, really struck them bad. So Florida, you know, you got these people. They kind of expect major devastation. Now, there were some issues. Beaches were eroded permanently, forever changed the landscape, roads washed out, and all this. But there just wasn't the major devastation that could have happened if it had made a direct landfall, even if it had fully re-strengthened and been a little bit more west than forecast. Yeah, it had been an absolute worst-case scenario for Florida. Instead, it wasn't. So what happens here is, as it goes up the coastline, people say, "Ah, well, Florida, they were fine. Look what happened there. Barely even nothing. There's no reason for me to pack up and leave my house and all this stuff." So you got these people saying, look, category what? Category, just a category 2? One hurricane at landfall? With some 84 mile per hour winds, so we stay indoors. We're fine. We got no issues here. So the only issue is, yeah, there's more issues than that. There's flooding and there's storm surge. And so as Matthew goes up the coast, he's going to encounter, basically, when it kind of gave it all it got over top of the inland Outer Banks, North Carolina, South Carolina. It dumped water. It dumped all it had, all that left in it. It basically just insane amount of water on top of these areas. And that became the issue with no one evacuated. I did this wrong, by the way. It's supposed to be one more down. Ta-da. Okay. So yeah, these people didn't evacuate, and the storm surge was awful. Tons of historic record flooding in North Carolina. And you got a Category 1 storm doing more damage than it did at a Category 4 state in Florida. And that's an issue. That's an issue for many reasons. For one, people didn't take the storm seriously. They said, well, that didn't do anything. We're fine here. We don't have to evacuate. I know they ordered us to, but hey, look at Florida. They ordered them to evacuate too, and they're fine. And the issue there is Florida, not really fine. Oh my gosh, we should have brought more leaves. Ugh, I need a stupid thing. It's at the other base. This is the issue with moving bases, and I don't bring all the tools that I need to bring. So we have to take a trip back. I'll try to finish up this conversation as well as I can. So yeah, we have a major issue here. For one, we have to figure out how to get public trust in order to trust us and to know when to evacuate. Sure, it could have been a different sampling of people. For example, people in Florida are different than North Carolina. There could be a tendency that people in Florida East are much more convinced to evacuate than those in North Carolina, but you could also go with the assumption that, yeah, we got an issue here and public trust just isn't as good. And number two, you gotta look at the way we rate storms. Like, as I said, a category 4 storm, basically the way hurricanes are rated is upon power of the storm. Not the impacts, but the power. So the pressure that it has, how deep of a storm it is, and how much wind is associated with that pressure. So this doesn't take into consideration that the Category 4 storms got really small, really tiny, just offshore, doesn't do much. Gets wider, gets weaker, does more, causes storm surge, way more damage than the Category 4 storm did at Florida. So we have to find a way to basically even that out, find a way to, I don't know, you know, just judge it based on, find a way to, you know, rate hurricanes so that we can rate them on impact, because the main reason that we're going to rate hurricanes, I assume, don't hold me to this, but main reason I would want us to rate hurricanes is for the public safety, and that didn't work, so obviously we might want to revisit this. I mean, yeah, you could argue it's for science and all of this, but at the same time, it's a branch of the government, and the purpose of the government is to essentially, let's see if I can find it here, we the people, blah, blah, blah. In order to form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic, wait. We the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity to ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States. That is the preamble. That is the first part of the Constitution. That basically says what the government's job is. And, well, what the government sure isn't defending our liberty or anything like that, or the National Hurricane Center isn't doing that job. What they're doing is the general welfare. They're keeping us safe, you know? That's what they're doing, essentially. So you gotta look at this and say, okay, that's what they're doing, then why would it be for science and not for the safety of the public? So essentially, I would argue that it is a branch of the government, and it should be there to protect us. The current system did not protect us very well, as many people did drown. Many people did die in North Carolina, way more than in Florida, and that's an issue. We gotta find a way to improve that, I believe. So yeah, that's my opinion on that. So something we can learn from Matthew, a storm that seemed to gladly disappoint at first, but then not disappoint in the end, is that we should really fix our system. I'm not gonna say it's broke, but it's pretty broke. And there's also the fact that the National Hurricane Center went down during Hurricane Matthew, which is not good, because, you know, public safety. You can't get information out to the public, and you are endangering their safety. So yeah, there's that. Aha, that's what I wanted. should have put that in the middle. Like right here. Like there, yeah. Alright, so there's one room. Here we go, here can be another one. Oops, I don't know what I did there, but whatever. That should be right. I think so. So yeah, that's my opinion on Matthew. 1, 2, 1, 2. Just gotta go back one more. So yeah, we didn't get a lot done there. I thought I was more prepared for this episode, but I wasn't. So I'm probably just gonna cut out until I have all of these rooms built. I would do a time lapse, but I mean, really, I've already done a lot this episode. I don't want to have to do another time lapse. So yeah, I'm just gonna cut out, finish it, and I'll come back in. Leave your thoughts on the comments below on what you think of Matthew and all of it in its entirety. So yeah, I'll be right back. Alrighty guys, so I've got them built. We've got the leads. All we gotta do is put the animals in their place. Have them go where they need to go. Ignore that noise, it's a dying hailstorm. It didn't turn into anything. Sadly. So here's a finished product to what it looks like. Basically this. The grass should be grown pretty shortly. Some of these are taking longer than others, especially the ones I just built. So, we should probably do this by importance. Cows, and then sheep, and then chickens, and then pigs. Oh, hold up, Bessie. Come on out. Come on. There you go. Okay, down the stairs we go. New home for you. Just for you guys. Come on. Gonna love it. Gonna love it. So roomy. So great. Over here. Just around the corner. Come on. Come on. Oh, I don't know if you can all fit in here at once. Oh yeah, two at a time. That's great. Great job, guys. Great job. Enjoy your new home. Okay, next ones. Next ones. We got the chickens. We don't even have to transfer these guys. We can just... we can just do this. Alright, there we go. Didn't even have to transfer the chickens. Y'all don't want to know what I'm going to do with the old ones. Okay, now we go to the sheep. Come on. Come on out. Y'all are going to love your new home. It's a lot better than there, trust me. I don't kill sheep either, so y'all are really going to like it. Got some grass for you, some lighting, some safety from the horrifying weather experiences upstairs. Take it to the slaughterhouse. Come on, man. Yeah, I know you see them. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. Come on. Okay. Here you are. The grass will grow back. Don't worry. Okay. Now we got the pigs and then the rabbits. Which is funny because these both eat carrots and they're both the last ones. So... pigs. Come on out. I'm probably not gonna kill you all. I'll just have you here. Just have all the animals. Same with the bunnies, you know. They're kind of just here. If I want a new pet one day, guess what? I'll just use you guys. Okay, come on. Early on, I'm gonna be killing the cows and the chickens. Maybe not even that. Maybe I'll eat a vegan diet. Pumpkin pie. Even though I'm gonna definitely kill the rest of those chickens for food. Come on now. Long episode here. Got a lot of editing to do. do. It's 3 a.m. Don't have a lot of time for this. Come on now. Almost there. Almost there. Notice how this is going to have a lot less... grass, because I just built it. This one has quite a bit. Oh, I forgot the rest of the leaves. That's a shame. To put them in this chest. Okay. Last ones. Here's the bunnies. Gotta get the bunnies. And then we will be all set. Hey there, guys. Oh, there. Oh, where'd your friend go? Hey. Fast, aren't you? Come on. Oh, now you're gonna go slow once I got you on a lead. Oh, I thought he was gonna break. I was like, great. I tried to make him an escape for it. Yeah, y'all probably won't like your new home. Just because, you know, y'all like a lot of space. You don't really have a lot of space. That's okay. Come on. Almost there. Gotta end this episode. So tired. Wanna go to bed. Have to get up early to edit it. Come on now. Come on. Come on. Up here. So close. So close. I don't even have a door. Thing for this. Yep, up here. Guess who? It's you. New home. Yippee. Boom, boom, boom. Boom. And yeah, there we go. Now just one last finishing touch. Cows. Chickens. Sheep. Pigs. And rabbits. Alrighty guys, that's gonna do it for this episode. Like, comment, subscribe if you all enjoyed. Got a lot done talking about Hurricane Matthew. If you wanted to see how tired I am, I built an extra room. I built too many rooms. That's okay. We'll figure out some of the courses in there or something. I don't know. Oh, hello. It's okay. Yeah, there you go. Get this whole space in here. You can go to the walls. Yeah, whatever. Like, comment, subscribe if you all enjoyed. See y'all in the next one. Bye.